Genesis chapter 35. And God said to Jacob, "Arise, go up to Bethel and dwell there, and make there an altar to God, who appeared to thee when thou fleddest from the face of Esau thy brother." Then Jacob said to his household and to all that were with him, "Put away the foreign gods that are among you, and purify yourselves, and change your garments, and let us arise and go up to Bethel, and I will make there an altar to God, who answered me in the day of my distress, and was with me in the way which I went." And they gave to Jacob all the foreign gods which were in their hand, and the rings which were in their ears, and Jacob hid them under the oak which was by Shechem. And they journeyed, and the terror of God was upon the cities that were round about them, and they did not pursue after the sons of Jacob. So Jacob came to Luz, which is in the land of Canaan, the same is Bethel, he and all the people that were with him, and he built there an altar, and called the place El Bethel, because there God was revealed to him, when he fled from the face of his brother. And Deborah, Rivka's nurse, died, and she was buried below Bethel, under the oak. And the name of it was called Alon Bakut, Oak of Weeping. And God appeared to Jacob again when he came from Paddan Aram, and he blessed him. And God said to him, "Thy name is Jacob. Thy name shall not be called any more Jacob, but Yisrael shall be thy name." And he called his name Yisrael. And Elohim, God, said to him, "I am El Shaddai. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation and a company of nations shall be of thee, and kings shall come out of thy loins. And the land which I gave to Abraham and Yitzhak, to thee I will give it, and to thy seed after thee will I give the land." And God went up from him in the place where he spoke with him. And Jacob set up a pillar in the place where he spoke with him, a pillar of stone, and he poured out a drink offering thereon, and poured oil thereon. And Jacob called the name of the place where God spoke with him Bethel, house of God. And they journeyed from Bethel, and there was still some distance to come to Ephrath. And Rachel travailed, and she had hard labor. And it was when she was in hard labor that the midwife said to her, "Fear not, for now thou shalt have another son." And it was as her soul was departing, for she died, that she called his name Ben-Oni, but his father called him Binyamin. Ben-Oni, son of my suffering. Binyamin, son of my right hand, that is, preferred son. And Rachel died and was buried in the way to Ephrath, the same is Bethlehem. And Jacob set up a pillar upon her grave, the same is the pillar of Rachel's grave to this day. And Yisrael journeyed and spread his tent beyond the tower of Eder. And it was, while Yisrael dwelt in that land, that Reuben went and lay with Bilhah his father's concubine. And Yisrael heard of it. Now the sons of Jacob were 12. The sons of Leah, Reuben, Jacob's firstborn, and Shimon and Levi, and Yehuda, and Yisshachar, and Zebulun. The sons of Rachel, Yosef and Binyamin. The sons of Bilhah, Rachel's handmaid, Dan and Naphtali. And the sons of Zilpah, Leah's handmaid, Gad and Asher. These are the sons of Jacob that were born to him in Paddan Aram. And Jacob came to Yitzhak his father to Mamre, to Kiryat Arba, the same is Hebron, where Abraham and Yitzhak sojourned. And the days of Yitzhak were 180 years. And Yitzhak expired and died, and was gathered to his people, old and full of days, and Esau and Jacob his sons buried him.